Hey everyone, I'm Pete Estes and welcome to another episode of Catamount Weekly presented by XFINITY. We've got major news to start today's show. America East and ESPN announced today an 11-year extension of their current media rights agreement. The 9-member institutions will now coordinate on-campus production operations for ESPN-level broadcasts of men's and women's basketball games, as well as other sports in coming years. Here's men's basketball coach John Becker on the impact of this new announcement.
The affiliation now with ESPN3 is a huge deal for our conference, for our program, and it should pay dividends in recruiting big time and just the quality of experience for our fans, to watch the games through ESPN and the Watch ESPN app. It's a big deal, and we really appreciate getting that deal done, and it takes a lot of time and resources to get this thing up and running, and it's been a collaborative effort, but we appreciate what our people are doing here and throughout the conference.
Basketball season now just one day away, and the women get things started on Friday night at Patrick Gym when the Bryant Bulldogs come to town. First-year head coach Chris Day and company look to start the season with a win for the second straight season. The homestand continues on Sunday with a 2 p.m. contest against Dartmouth. The men begin the season with 3 games in 5 days, starting with a Saturday afternoon matchup at Quinnipiac. Monday night, the Cats take on Providence of the Big East. That game will be televised on Fox Sports 2, and tip-off is scheduled for 7 p.m. The 3-game road swing wraps up on Wednesday night at Marist. Vermont has won 7 straight games against the Red Foxes, including an 86-60 win last season at Patrick Gym. Several UVM students made the quick trek down to the Sheridan in Burlington to speak with high school students at the Vermont Student Athlete Leadership Conference. Catamount TV was there.
You're going to class, leaving class, coming back, got practice, just like you do. Busy schedules. But you find out, one of the examples is the people that lead best are the ones that aren't afraid to work outside their comfort zone and just do what needs to happen. And you guys are great representatives of the University of Vermont, and I'm really very, very proud to have you here.
Just think about the definition between a captain versus a leader. A captain, I feel like, is a title, whereas leadership is what you bring to the table and the care and quality that you give to your team.
Look at other leaders that you've had in your life that have been meaningful to you, and take from your relationship with them the things that you thought were most beneficial and apply it.
You know, as a leader, you have to go out of your way to try to make things work. So, you know, form those relationships.
Yeah, just talk to everyone. Talk to all the members of your team. Become friends with them.
And then that way you're not saying, hey guys, I know we have school all day and then we have practice, and now you're going to come back on Thursday night for like this extra activity. People might not buy into that, but there's smaller ways to do it for sure.
It's like, don't step on these girls' toes, but you can still do everything that you would have been able to do to be a leader without the title. And that'll really show, okay? And next year, you'll probably be a captain.
That'll do it for us today on Catamount Weekly presented by XFINITY. Plenty more next week right here on Catamount TV.